It's a big day of Ayodhya verdict, and I'm already seeing on social media, it's a Saturday, people are waking up and people are now genuinely getting interested. The curiosity level will only rise as we get closer to the 10:30 a.m. mark. That's the time when the five-judge bench of the Supreme Court will assemble, led by the Chief Justice himself, who, by the way, is now entering his last week. Starting Monday, the last week of the justice, of the Chief Justice, Justice Gogoi, starts. And he's got a packed week. He's got to deliver judgments in the Sabarimala case. He's got to deliver judgments in the Rafael case. He's beginning, or I should say that he's concluding this week with the biggest of them all, the big Ayodhya judgment. Maria Shakil is there and Anand Narasimhan is there at the Supreme Court as well. And we're joined by an esteemed set of guests first thing in the morning here this Saturday. Advaita Kala, Maulana Kasmi, Ajay Gautam and Vijay Shankar Pandey. Maria, I'm looking at the spate of press conferences which have been planned. 11:30 a.m. the Muslim Personal Law Board gives its response. 1 p.m. the RSS boss speaks. 2:30 p.m. the VHP speaks. Just tell me, across the, on the opposition side as well, where is the Congress in this entire scheme of things? How are they looking at this day today?
I think there'll be a degree of caution, particularly on the opposition side, because as we have been saying, Bhupen, this is of course a landmark moment, not only in the history of the country, but also the polity at large, because they will be able to recalibrate their stand on a number of issues. And what judgment comes from the Supreme Court will force a number of political parties, particularly the regional parties, to revisit their own ideology, their own philosophy, and their own beliefs. And hence, that's the reason why we have been saying that it is not just about that 2.77 acres of land. And particularly, Bhupen, when I speak to a number of politicians across party lines, some of them do highlight that the Allahabad High Court judgment was something which was more based on guesswork, and that it was more about myths and superstition and less on facts. So certainly when you're talking about the judgment today, we'll be looking at the facts, and there'll be a lot of I would say a calibrated statement that will be coming and may not come from most political parties immediately. All of them would be looking at the finer points of the judgment, and only perhaps later in the day, or maybe tomorrow or day after, a detailed press conference can be expected from a press from the Congress party. But at the same time, roughly around 9:30, 9:45, there is an important Congress working committee meeting that will be taking place. So the best part would be that the motor mouth of any political party will all be in that meeting, so that they will not be indulging in any kind of immediate reaction, which is certainly avoidable at this stage.
Yeah, certainly. I couldn't agree more with you, Maria. I think that we need to keep the motor mouths away. I distinctly remember in 2010 when the Allahabad High Court verdict was being delivered, I myself was in Lucknow when suddenly there was a battery of lawyers who all came while the judgment was still being read out, and they all came with their own interpretations. So my request to all the reporters, including Anand, Maria and all our battery of reporters who are there at various locations, beware, this is a very complicated case. There are various questions which are at play. Just because a judge has started to say something doesn't mean that that is the final verdict. We need to wait. We need to wait. So Anand, my question is there any clarity? Are we looking at one judgment today, Anand? Are we looking at five judgments, four judgments? Any clarity there?
Well, there are multiple suits, and that's what we need to be very, very clear of. First up, what will be disposed of is a matter raised by the Shia Waqf Board, who claimed the right because it was Mir Baqi, who was a Shia, who built the masjid in the first place. So that will be one matter that will be heard. The other suit is of Gopal Singh Visharad, who claims the right to worship there. That will be the next suit that will be then, verdict will be pronounced on that. Then you have the Nirmohi Akhada, which claims the right to Shibayat, or management and control of the site and of the deity. So that, and they have also said that it has been the Nirmohi Akhada which has been performing the puja and the worship, so they should get the right to Shibayat. So that is another matter. The fourth matter is suit number four, when it comes, is the Sunni Waqf Board, who claim that they have the title and the ownership because there is a mosque, and the ownership of that site belongs to the Sunni Waqf Board. So that is their position. And then you have Ram Lala Virajman, who come out and say that there's nobody can own this place because this belongs to a holy entity, that's a deity itself, and this entire site is Ram Lala Virajman, it belongs to them. So there are four, five matters that will be disposed of one after the other in terms of verdict being pronounced. So at each level, we'll have to be careful as to what the matter is and what the judges are saying. So at 10:30, the first judgment would be whether or not Shia Waqf Board has any claim to this site, because this is a tussle between Shia and Sunni, so that will be talked about, disposed of. The Shia Waqf Board's position, Bhupen, has been that if it is awarded in their favour, within 1 hour itself, they will hand over the land to the Hindu Paksh and tell them to go ahead and build the temple. But That's where it will start. Then Gopal Singh Visharad, his right to worship, and that's where he was one of the older litigants also, one of the individual litigants in the Hindu Paksh. So his litigation, thereafter Sunni Waqf Board and Nirmohi Akhada Sunni Waqf Board, and then finally, whether or not it is Ram Lala Virajman who owns this entire place and the presiding deity of the Janmasthan.
Okay, Anusha.
As far as the Hindu Paksh or the Hindu Mahasabha's position.
Right, Anusha. Anusha is there as well, and Shreya Dhundial, of course, reporting live from Ayodhya. But Shreya, Anusha, just a quick clarification, Anusha. When the Chief Justice actually starts reading out the judgment, I want to know, will the Chief Justice be the last person who will read out the judgment? I mean, is there any clarity which judge will begin first?
You know, Bhupendra, usually the convention is the presiding judge begins reading the entire judgment, okay? In a scenario where the Chief Justice of India is in the minority judgment, because it's a constitution bench judgment, only in those cases you would often see the Chief Justice or the presiding judge reading the judgment last. Unless it's a unanimous judgment, which is the same judgment coming from all the judges, if it's a majority versus the minority judgment, the majority judgment is read out first. Because the listing is in such manner, we do not know how many judgments are written, who's going to read it first, because usually in listing, it is indicative of how it's going to come forward. The convention dictates that the presiding judge who's leading the bench reads the judgment. In this case, the Chief Justice of India, Ranjan Gogoi. One more thing, Bhupendra, I want to tell our viewers, I'm just coming from inside, outside Chief Justice of India's court, court number one. The corridor is entirely packed. The gates of the courtroom have not been opened so far. Usually at this time, they're open, but it's a Saturday. The security restrictions in the court have been tightened even further. So even the lawyers who are coming to the court, who usually can walk around and roam around freely, enter the courtroom premises, today passes are being asked for. That are you a concerned party in the matter? Why do you want to enter? Security here inside the courtroom has been tightened much more than what we saw in the morning.
And no, that's what I'm trying to understand, Anusha. You know, the security tightened, access to the courtroom limited. In this kind of a scenario, is there no special arrangement being made today to ensure the dissemination of information once the judgment starts being read out? And Alan and I were talking about it, you know, there are multiple cases, various questions. How is the dissemination of information really going to take place today? Is there any special arrangement which has been made?
No, there is no special arrangement which was made. In fact, there was a discussion as well which was going on that for instances like these, technology should have been used. Live streaming is something that the Supreme Court has itself talked about for very important cases. You'd remember earlier there was a suggestion as well that had come that the Ayodhya entire matter before the Constitution bench should be live streamed. But no such arrangement seen as of now. I can tell you as a court reporter, sometimes the mics which are kept on the judges' dais, even they are not used.
Precisely.
Sometimes even in the courtroom when the judge is reading the judgment, you're not able to hear it from the back. Most of the times the court reporters rely on each other to get the words together. Today in this case we are expecting that the mics are going to work. The connectivity, especially the mobile connectivity inside the court premises, is very slow. The social media is not working, internet messages are not going through, and I can tell our viewers that information dissemination is going to be very slow today because of the connectivity issue, and the judgment is being delivered in a very old style where it's being read out. So clearly everyone is going to exercise caution here, and that is how the information is going to trickle in, Bhupen.
Yes, absolutely. And that's the reason why, Anusha, I was seeking clarity on that, because of a lot of people are asking if there are these five questions which are there before the judges, and there are five judges, if there are five judgments, how will we know what is the judgment? At what stage do we know exactly what is a majority view? If there is a majority view, if there's a consensus view, at what stage do we actually get to figure that out? But Pallavi Ghosh is live with us as well. She's at the residence of Kapil Sibal. Pallavi, how is the Congress Party, Pallavi, looking at this entire question, this entire gamut of emotions and questions that we're looking at? What's at stake for the Congress today?
Well, they're going to have a Congress Working Committee meeting, which was actually scheduled for tomorrow, but they decided to prepone it. So definitely the focus of the CWC is going to be on that big Ayodhya verdict. And in the midst of all this, the Congress has made it very, very clear that no one is going to speak out of line. In fact, Sonia Gandhi had already set up a core team a few days back. And one of the main tasks of the core team, really, Bhupen, was to kind of structure the kind of an official reaction coming in from the Congress Party. No loose words, because they know that any wrong word could always be open to interpretations, and that could be politically boomerang on the Congress party. So they certainly don't want to take any chances. No one wants to speak out of turn. No one, in fact, wants to speak, Bhupen. So I think once the verdict comes in, the Congress working committee meeting is going to be held simultaneously at Sonia Gandhi's residence in a short while from now. Mm. And we are going to get that official reaction coming in from the Congress. But of course, the underlying thought within the Congress party is that whatever is the court's wording, we are going to abide by it.
All right, let's see a bit of a short break. I've always maintained when the story is big, India's biggest news network always unveils its best faces across different territories. So from Shreya Dondial to Anand Narasimhan, Pallavi Ghosh, Maria Shakil, Anusha, Utkarsh Anand, you don't get a better set of journalists than the ones who are on air right now. So we'll sip into a short break, come back with hopefully some answers to all these complexities that we're looking at today.